year 2010, from the depths of the snow-covered mountains of Siberia, a secret emerged, one that had remained hidden in the cold silence of millennia. A small bone, a fragment of a young woman's finger, was pulled from the depths of Denisova cave. There, in the Altai Mountains, at the crossroads where Russia, Mongolia, China, and Kazakhstan nearly touch, a cave once inhabited by a monk named Denis in the 18th century, now lending its name to one of the most astonishing anthropological discoveries of our time. What first appeared to be an ordinary fossil opened a new world with the rise of genetic science. When the DNA of that bone was decoded, researchers faced a stunning truth. This was neither Neanderthal nor modern human, but an unknown kind of hominin distinct from both. Initially dubbed X-woman, she soon acquired a name that would endure, Denisovan. What astonished scientists even more was the genetic distance between this being and ourselves. Studies conducted at the Max Planck Institute revealed that Denisovans differ from modern humans even more than Neanderthals do. And yet, they, too, are part of our family. A distant relative, yes, but a real one. The remains found in Denisova Cave suggest that the site was inhabited multiple times throughout history, by Denisovans between 287 and 203,000 years ago, and later by Neanderthals from around 193 to 97,000 years ago. No definitive evidence of their simultaneous presence has been found. Yet this does not mean they were entirely separate. Their genomes tell another story, a story of overlap, interbreeding, and a complex web of biological connection. In 2010, a single bone fragment, just a sliver from the finger of a teenage girl, was enough to open a new gateway into our understanding of the human past. A small bone left behind in the darkness of Denisova Cave, deep within the Altai Mountains of Siberia. Today, we know this girl by the nickname Deni, a child of about 13 years old who lived nearly 90,000 years ago. But what made her truly extraordinary in the story of human evolution was neither her age nor her location. It was her genetic identity. She was not just Denisovan, not just Neanderthal, she was the child of both. Her mother, Neanderthal, her father, Denisovan. Deni is the first hybrid human ever identified through genetic evidence. A living testament to the fact that interbreeding between these two human lineages did occur, and perhaps it wasn't rare at all. But this was not the only secret hidden in her DNA. Roughly 4% of her genome pointed to something even older, another ancient human, a being more mysterious than the Denisovans themselves. Scientists believe this unknown lineage descended from an early migration out of Africa nearly 1.9 million years ago. These findings rewrite an old narrative, a story not of strict separation, but of dispersion, blending, and perhaps long-lasting coexistence among human species once thought entirely apart. High in the Tibetan plateau, where oxygen is thin and the cold is relentless, a Buddhist monk discovered the lower jaw of an ancient human in Baishia Karst Cave. For years, the specimen remained unstudied until 2019, when a research team finally managed to sequence a portion of its DNA. Miraculously well-preserved, its genetic code revealed a close kinship with the Denisovans of Siberia. This jawbone, now known as Xiahi, is over 160,000 years old. And once again, it challenged the assumptions of science. It was long believed that survival in such high-altitude environments was a triumph unique to modern humans. But here, in one of Earth's harshest climates, appeared signs of a forgotten species, alive in the thin air and echoing through time. Just like the Xiahi specimen, it is possible that some of the fossil remains uncovered by archaeologists in past decades may also belong to Denisovans. But due to the degradation of organic tissue and the inability to extract DNA from them, no definitive conclusion can be made, at least not yet. As explained earlier, only bone or tooth material that has been exceptionally well preserved retains organic matter from which DNA can be recovered. But in fossils, mineral-rich sediments gradually replace the bone's organic components, turning them to stone and erasing the delicate strands of genetic code. Denisova cave itself once stood in a temperate and relatively moist conifer forest, but over time, the landscape shifted, giving way to cold tundra. In contrast, the Baishia karst cave sits high in the Tibetan plateau, an unforgiving land defined by low temperatures, thin air, and scarce resources. Before the Jahi jawbone was studied, it was widely believed that survival in such high-altitude environments was a feat only modern humans had achieved. But in 2018, a new discovery deepened the mystery. A team of anthropologists from Laos, France, and the United States, who had been excavating limestone caves in the Annamite Mountains since 2008, were guided by local children to an ancient site known as Tam Ngu Hao, or Cobra Cave. There, they found a single tooth, a human molar belonging to a child, estimated to be between 3.5 and 8.5 years old at the time of death. Based on its characteristics and comparison with previous finds, the team classified it as belonging to a Denisovan, though the possibility that it came from a Neanderthal has not been definitively ruled out. The age of the tooth dates back between 164,000 and 131,000 years ago. So far, the fossil remains of the Denisovans, bones and teeth, have been discovered in Siberia, Tibet, and Laos. But the traces of their genes, hidden within the DNA of modern humans, tell a different story, a story of widespread presence across Eurasia, and perhaps even into Oceania. Are we the inheritors of a shared and intricate legacy? Do fragments of Denisovan, of Neanderthal, and maybe even of other unknown humans still live within us? These questions remain, buried deep in the darkness of ancient caves and etched silently in the strands of DNA, awaiting answers. DNA is the silent memory of our past. Within it lie footprints we can no longer uncover in the earth. Today we know we, modern humans, are not the product of a single lineage. Our genome bears witness. We are a mosaic of many human branches. Woven into the very fabric of our DNA are clear signs of two ancient groups, the Neanderthals and the Denisovans. This blending happened not just once, but many times in many corners of the world. As if, from the very beginning, humans were breaking through the boundaries of race, intertwining, learning from one another, and living side by side. Among all people alive today, the indigenous peoples of Melanesia and certain tribes in the Philippines carry the highest percentage of Denisovan DNA, in some cases more than 5%. Such a legacy clearly suggests that Denisovans once spread as far as New Guinea, Australia, and Southeast Asia. Some genetic evidence even indicates that this interbreeding may have continued until as recently as 30,000 years ago. Even the Icelanders, inhabitants of the frozen north, bear traces of Denisovan ancestry in their genes, likely inherited from groups that once lived in the western Altai Mountains. But this ancient blending is not just a relic of the past. Some of the genes passed down from the Denisovans are still active in our bodies today. One such gene, believed to be inherited from Denisovans who once lived in the highlands of Asia, enables Tibetan people to survive in high-altitude, low-oxygen environments. In this sense, the Denisovan legacy exists not only in our DNA, but in the very breath we take. And now, this enigmatic face is beginning to take clearer shape. Denisovans are no longer known only by a scattering of bones. According to the latest studies published in Science and Cell, proteomic analysis and ancient DNA extracted from dental plaque have revealed something extraordinary, that a nearly complete skull, known as Homo longi, in fact belonged to this extinct human lineage, a massive skull from northeastern China with a brain volume of approximately 1,420 cubic centimeters and a broad, powerful face with thick brows and deep-set eyes. now stands as one of the most likely portraits of what a Denisovan may have truly looked like. A fusion of primitive and advanced features, from a structure reminiscent of Neanderthals to subtle distinctive traits never seen before. This reconstruction will be shaped not only by strands of DNA, but by the tangible truth of bone, by the contours of what was. And in the depths of those genes, the echoes of a distant past still linger. Dark skin, brown eyes, black hair, and genetic threads that continue to live on within us. Inside Denisova cave, not only stone tools were found, but also ivory pendants, marble rings, carved deer teeth, bone needles, and bracelets crafted with remarkable delicacy. Were these objects made by Denisovans or by modern humans who arrived in Siberia much later? We still do not know, but their coexistence in this place bears witness, perhaps to a moment when two worlds met. And wonder was not confined to the caves alone. In 1998, high upon the Tibetan plateau, where the rocks speak in the language of wind, the handprints and footprints of several children were discovered, etched into a bed of travertine stone. Dated between 170,000 and 230,000 years ago, these are the oldest known signs of human presence on the plateau. And given the age of the Jahi jawbone, it is likely that these footprints belonged to Denisovan children, children who played, who ran through warm springs, and who, without knowing it, left behind a trace that would never fade. Did the Denisovans also create art? Did they sing by the firelight in their caves, or tell stories? We do not yet know, but this we do know. The story of humanity is not ours alone. It is a story with many voices, many branches, and many kinds, all traveling for a moment in time together. Every discovery is a new window into the past, but no window reveals the whole view. The Denisovan, with all their mystery, reminds us of this truth, that what made us was never a single straight line, but a complex web of connection, of rivalry, of interbreeding, and of forgetting. And perhaps this is the true meaning of being human. To live at the edges, and to be shaped in the company of others. We are the heirs of those who are no longer here, and yet they still breathe within us.